morning, guys, from GR11 trail, Pyrenees, Spain. We had uneven terrain today to sleep, very hilly, and so it wasn't very comfortable. Also, we slept close to the farm and it was quite noisy at night with the cows, horses, pigs, and it was a disturbing sleep.
Today we'll do another 13 kilometers and we'll get closer to the Spanish-French border again today. And we see on the map that it's going to be mostly downhill, but with the little ups, you know, with the little hills to do. Also, we're getting today to the village Bera, where we really hope to do some grocery shopping because we ran out of many stuff, like cereals and like basic stuff that we eat every day. And today is Sunday, so it is very challenging. We don't know if it's going to be open or maybe everything's going to be shut down. As always, it happens, but sometimes it's open until 13 p.m. or 12 p.m. So our goal is to be in time for them to be open. And yeah, we see that the weather is sunny from the very morning. And maybe it's going to be warm, but we see that it's not going to be too hot, which we're very glad about. So let's start the day. Just past the interesting site, located right on the Spanish-French border, where there is just a hotel and restaurant and several buildings. And we read on the info board that it is a great observation point for the migrations of birds. So from the middle of August till the middle of November, there's huge groups of birds of different species flying over these peaks, these hills, towards from the France and north of Europe, towards the south of Spain and Africa probably. So this is very curious to know and interesting. The area that we are hiking right now is very peculiar because of the different people from France and Spain, Basque country, and thus different languages. So now we met three people and three of them said to us different hello. So in different kind of way that sometimes we don't understand because we don't know the Basque language. It's pretty difficult, but yeah, it's like very interesting. And right now we're hiking on the easy road, which we even seen the car passing by. So yeah, so far so good, and going fine and easy. Clouds below us, we're wondering how do they choose where to form, in which valley, in which place. This is very curious to see, like here there are no clouds and somewhere lower there are clouds. This is so beautiful to see, and we're going into them, so it's gonna be cloudy for the rest of the day probably. Thank you. now following this gravel secondary car road right to the town, because we want to be in time, as we said, for the shops to be open. And so we choose to do the shortcut to take the direct route to the village instead of going over one hill that we skip, that we choose to skip because of that. And yeah, we think it's gonna be fine and we're gonna be in time. And it's still going pretty steep, but it's okay. We should be there in 1 hour or so, because it's around 3 kilometers. Through these places and lots of roads, we can see that there are plenty of possibilities to explore the hills, and there are different routes, even to go by car, but to go by bike it would be perfect, we think. And we even think maybe to go back here one time with our bikes and just, you know, to cycle around and explore more and walk around as well, because it's a pretty lovely area, very beautiful and kind of inaccessible. Now just left the village Bera and Zalain behind us. We were able to do our grocery shopping. Luckily, the local guy helped us, directed us to the little shop that was open, that wasn't marked on the Google Maps nor other maps. So it proves the fact that it's important to ask the local people if you are not sure. Like we were today, it's Sunday and everything's closed, and you know, you're just left hungry for that. And yeah, so now we're out of the village. We have a bit of uphill to do to the water fountain, and probably we'll start scouting for the camp spot there. And right now we're crossing like very little part, 100-200 meters part of the cycling way, which actually starts in Pamplona and ends in Irun. So it's good for doing touring through these hills and mountains. It's around 120 kilometers long. So it's really nice for several days, or you know, depending how fast you go. And yeah, we just thought it is worth mentioning.
Almost at the end of the day, just had our lunch here in the shade, and now we have a quest again finding the camp spot, which continues to be a very difficult task in this hilly and ferny terrain.
Everything we see around is the fern, which is like you can't get through it. It's very like dense and jungle-like, so it's practically impossible to get through it. So we have to search for little chunks of the trees and the forest and hope for the better, that we don't have to stretch very far away, like do extra kilometers of the next day. But we'll see what we got, and we'll show you around.
The day was easy, mostly going downhill. Just this last part was steep and quite hot in the middle of the day. But the weather continues to be nice and comfortable, with cool winds and plus 23 degrees Celsius.
So basically the best ideal weather for hiking, we think. Even in the sun, in the direct sun, it's bearable, you know. So yeah, so right, as you said, hope for the better, fingers crossed, we'll find the spot soon. And the water, close to the water source, which is also very important because, right, carrying the water is not an easy task, right? So yeah, see you there, guys. And for now, saying goodbye, as always, and until the next day. Finally see the ocean in the distance. Can you see it behind me? This is such a happy moment. We've been waiting for it for the last couple of days and we've been expecting to see it several days before, but we can only see it now and we can't be happier because this was our goal, to reach the ocean coast, the Cantabrian Sea. So yeah, now we can see our goal. It's gonna be easier to walk and with even more motivation. And right now we still didn't find any spots. It's already 4 p.m. but it's okay because, you know, we normally don't set up a tent before 5 or 6 p.m. or until the dusk. So yeah, but well, we see some more or less flat spots in the forest, so probably we'll stop there. And yeah, who knows where we end up being today, but this is already a happy encounter and so nice. So tomorrow we're gonna see lots of beautiful ocean views, probably, like of the coast and everything. So yeah, can't wait for tomorrow to come.
Thanks a lot for watching. Hope you enjoyed this hiking trip. If so, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more hiking adventures. Don't forget to hit the bell to stay notified about every new video. Visit our website walkingnatureworld.com to find detailed hike reports with pictures and maps. Hope you have a wonderful day and we'll see you very soon.